So, hello everyone, my name is Ravindra and I welcome you to my channel. In this video, we will see how to write in JavaScript in model driven apps or in Dynamics 365. So, let's I show you the demo, okay, how it's work. Okay, if you see, whenever I just loading my form, okay, at that time I just receiving one alert message, okay, like load, okay. If I write an email here, okay, so email is changed, okay, so this type of JavaScript, okay. Hi Ravindra, so how to write this type of JavaScript into an model driven app or in the Dynamics 365 on the forms? So this thing we are seeing, okay, so let's go and open in Visual Studio and see we are just open a Visual Studio code editor, okay. If you not have, you can install this or you can use any code editor tool, okay, that is not preferable, you have to use Visual Studio. So let's simply click on the new file. Let's type here client script.js. Okay, so for that purpose, let's I show you the Microsoft documentation. From there, you can take the referral, okay, how to write JS in the forms. Okay, so let's I switch the tab. And simply you have to search on the Google scripts in model driven apps, okay, then the first link you will receive, okay, walkthrough write your first client script in model driven apps, okay. So just simply open that and then you can see the entire documentation how to write and client side script. Everything was going step wise. You can follow this as well, okay, or either you can use the ChatGPT also, okay. Like here I have using, you have to write an client side script in model driven app or in Dynamics 365 or web resource. When form loads, display alert message, and message is your form is loaded successfully. ChatGPT not only gives us the JavaScript file, also it gives us the content, okay, how to create in the stepwise manner, okay. So if you see in Dynamics 365, navigate to the settings, solutions, open existing solution, create new one, okay, then click on the web resources and then type the JavaScript. So everything stepwise given, okay. For now, let's we copy this code, okay, we require this only, and let's paste this into a VS code, okay. So let's I explain you this code, okay. We are just calling a function, given name to that onload alert, okay. Execution context we are passing, but here is a no meaning of that, okay, and then simply just using alert message, okay, the form is loaded successfully. Let's click on the save, okay. Let's go to the model driven application, okay. So I'm in the solution, okay, in the solution just simply click on the new, sorry, go to the auth first, then click on the new, click on more. At here we have option web resources, click on the web resources. Let's choose the file whose name to this account script, okay, because I am writing this script on the account table, that's why I use here account scripts, okay, and let's click on the save. So our script is created. Let's we go to our account table, okay, You can go to the any table. We are just loading the script on the form. So let's we click on the form. Let's choose main form. Okay, we have to load the script onto the main form. So let's click on the main form. After that, we have form properties. Simply just click on the form properties. Okay, go to the events. Here two events are present: on save, whenever you are saving your form. Okay, like if I go to my file, okay, and go to the accounts. Okay, new, here is one option is present in the Modrio app, save. Okay, whenever you use here event handler on save, okay, at that time whenever you save the record, at that time this function will call. So in this case we have to call on the onload. Okay, so let's click on the onload. Let's select here our web resource. Okay, so simply just click on this pencil icon. Just simply click on the add library, and here just passing out, let's search our script. Okay, here we have our script ABC account scripts. Okay, I think we forget to give the display name, so that's why here not coming. In our next edition, let's we update that. Just click on the add. And let's choose there ABC account scripts. Okay, and let's pass here our function name. Okay, let's I go to the VS code, copy this function name, let's paste it here and simply click on the done. And then save and publish. Then simply refresh our form here. Okay, you have to do the hard refresh by pressing F5, or just you can be go to the left corner and then click on the refresh. So let's do one more time. One step back. So simply in the account list, whenever I just go to the new, okay, so you can see one alert notification is displaying. Your form is loaded successfully. So you can click on OK and you can add the details here. Okay, so this is one action. Okay, in this way you can add the JavaScript. Okay.